Welcome to DARPA Subterranean Challenge, the cave circuit. 16 teams from all over the world, well, they're testing their autonomous systems virtually.
Clearly, this is the world's top research groups coming together to solve this unique challenge.
There are a lot of lessons learned that you can learn from simulation where it might be too costly or dangerous or time-consuming to go out and test in the real world.
We think that the virtual is a chance to showcase ourselves. Our initial goals for our robots are to go find artifacts.
The test is just Pac-Man. Everywhere we haven't been, there's a little dot, and our robots gobbled them up.
In the virtual, everything is on the robots.
In this cave world, it's much harder to navigate with rovers, so for the first time, we're using drones.
Even if you're by yourself working, you know, working alone, you can still accomplish big things. Me, these are the Super Bowl of the engineering and scientist community.
You know, learning new technologies, collaborating and exchanging experiences, information with some of the other teams, just, you know, participating in this part of the research is the reason why we are doing it.
We've seen teams conquer these cave environments by dispersing their multi-robot teams throughout and really deep into these huge cave terrains.
Well, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Who in the world has won DARPA Subterranean Challenge? The cave circuit.
Our top place winner, Coordinated Robotics. In second place, Team Barks. In third place overall, we have Team Dynamo. $100,000 prize, Team Robotica. The $150,000 prize, Team Dynamo. And finally, the $250,000 prize goes to, of course, Team Coordinated Robotics. The systems competition and the virtual competition keep getting closer and closer, which means that the lessons that we learn in the virtual domain will hopefully impact positively in the physical domain. Great job, and congratulations to all of you who contributed to the virtual competition.